The clean and place report can be created in a variety of manners. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create the clean and place report from a historian, which in our case is a FactoryTalk View SE, and I'm using the data log models, by selecting the database of the data log models. XLReporter immediately picks up the tables. And in conjunction with that, I'm going to use a PLC that's going to indicate the start and the stop of a cycle so that I know how much information to pull out of the historian. So these two connectors are going to be working together to produce me my CIP report. As for the template, we're inside Excel. There's a lot of Excel functionality that's been put in. Key point here is that this area is populated by the PLC based on the cycle selected by the operator. And this chart here is populated based on the start and end times of the cycle. Now, at the heart of this template is a schedule. And it's probably best that we first understand the schedule to better understand the report template. The schedule essentially is driven off one bit in the PLC, a cycle start, and it reacts to when the cycle start goes high and when it goes low. Now, when it goes high, four different things occur. Number one, we go and read in the PLC the cycle vessel number and we store it in one of our variables. We go and get the cycle ID and store it in one of our variables. We get the current time, that would be the time when the cycle started, and store it in a variable. And then we update the sheet, paying close attention to updating group one. If I now go into the connector, I can see that all the updates of one essentially bring in the values of the variables and then the values of the real-time values. Notice the use of arrays. So in this particular case, the cycle name from registers 0 to 9 are going to populate in this area here. The scheduler also reacts when the cycle ends. It sets the start time or the end time to another register, and then it updates group 2. If I have a look inside our template, we make use of the end time and we put it into C9. And then we update the template with data from my FactoryTalk View SE, which is going to take advantage of the fact that the start and end times have been stored in these two variables. So if I open it up, I can see the columns that are going to be read from the FactoryTalk View SE, and on the time period tab, I start from the two variables that have been locked in when events occurred in the PLC. The data is going to be pulled out in 30-second intervals between these two timestamps. Finally, at the report name level, what we're going to ask for, and I'm still going to make use of these variables, we're going to create a folder based on this register that contains the vessel ID, and then what we're going to do is create the report based on the date and time and the cycle ID. So let's see what it looks like when it's finished. Open up workbook reports, and if I go to my clean in place reports, it's created a folder after my fermenter, and it's created a file which is named after the date followed by the CIP cycle number. The steps in the report are based on information that was read from the PLC, and the start and end times, which were latched by the scheduler, are used to pull out the information for the chart. Notice the use of dynamic labels. These labels are an extension of Excel provided by XLReporter to annotate relevant spots during the cycle to highlight when things started and stopped.